Okay, this is Josh. I'm all done with the Oregon Trail. As you noticed, Steve, the banker, made it to Willamette Valley. So where do you go after Willamette Valley? You go into space. Oregon to space. If you didn't know, that's the natural progression of things. So we're here on the archive again, and I thought we'd do a full, complete playthrough of Sex Vixens from Space by Free Spirit Software Incorporated, published 1989. So let's begin. I checked around YouTube and I didn't find a single complete playthrough of, oh my god, okay. Wonderful. Let's go full screen so we can really take this all in. Really take it all in. I don't want to miss a thing. You ready? I'm ready. You are Captain Brad Stallion, owner and operator of the one-man space vehicle known throughout the galaxy as the Ellipses. Big Thruster. Oh, of course it's the Big Thruster. What else would it be? What else would it be? At various times throughout your career, you have worked for the Galactic Rulers as a special agent, spying and lying. Yeah, I'm assuming they mean lying with women, because, yeah. For years, there have been rumors about the Tribe, a colony of beautiful, sex-starved women somewhere in space. According to many legends, they suddenly appear, suddenly appear, raid the male-dominated rural planetary systems with their sex ray gun. Leaving the men sexless eunuchs. The Federated government has hired you to find and stop them. Wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful. I'm sure I'm up to the task. I'm dying inside. Space! You are at the control room door. To the south is the ship's passageway. To the north is the control panel. Let's see what's down south. You're in the main passageway of your ship. To the east is your cabin. To the south is the airlock. West is the cargo hold. Let's check out my digs. All right. Got that whole gray thing going on. We have a inappropriate poster. And a sink that is out of order. So that's great. So, depending on how much time I spend with this poster, my hands are probably really disgusting. Wonderful. Here's the cargo hold. You're in the cargo hold filled with precious, with crates of the priceless aphrodisiac orgasium. I'm gonna leave those right there. I'm not even gonna touch those. So let's go back. Go into the control room. Brad, you're in the control room of your spaceship. In front of you is the control panel and captain's chair. To the south is an open door. Press button. Alert, alert, alert. You're ordered to the Federated Planet 1. A maid at the Pink Flamingo Hotel named Lila is suspected of connection with the Tribe. Find out what she knows. I bet we pump her for information. Use any means necessary. The course has been fed into your navigational computer. Good luck, Brad. Thanks. Thanks for that. You're in the captain's chair of your spaceship. In front of you is the control panel. Well, we're gonna have to blast off. Engine start. Blast off. Press any key. Continue. You barely feel the pressure as the Big Thruster's anti-inertial system takes over during blastoff. You are on the course fed into the navigational computer. You begin your journey. Many days pass. You then arrive on the Federation Planet 1. Your ground transportation is waiting. Okay. Get out of your chair. Hitman. I know. I know. I'm in the chair. Get out of the chair. I know. Go south. We need the airlock. Airlock. Open the airlock. The airlock opens. Go into the airlock. You're at the foot of the ship's ladder. Above you is the airlock. East is the open field and a grav car. Go to the grav car. You're standing below a Federated planet grav car. Big thruster is to the west. Oh my god. Get in the grav car. You're not able to go down. Get in the grav car. Okay. You're inside the Planet One automated grav car. There are no visible controls. I bet it's got touch controls. Touching controls. Like, grabbing things. Alright, go to our inventory. Galactic Plastic Money Card. Okay, get the card. You have a Galactic Plastic Money Card in your right hand. Insert the card. Grav car active pilot on. The grav car slowly and gently transports you to the Pink Flamingo Hotel. To the north is the hotel lobby. Go north. You're in the lobby of the Pink Flamingo Hotel. North is the hotel registration desk. South is the grav car. Go to the desk. You're at the registration desk. The lobby is south. A grav lift is west. You see a coin on the counter. Now get the coin. I want that coin, yo. You place it in your pocket. Press any key to continue. Yeah, I did that. Okay. Go to my inventory. Get my card. Okay. Talk to the robot. Okay, talk to the robot. Talk to the robot. Okay. Go south. Go north. Okay. The robot clerk, welcome to the Grand Flamingo. To register, please hand me your Galactic Plastic Money Card. Okay. Get card. Give card. The robot clerk registers you. Press any key to continue. Go to the lift. Get my card out again. Give the card. Get card. Why can't you perform that command? Okay. You're facing a turbograv lift with no controls but a slot in the wall. The registration desk is to the east. Okay. Get card. Insert. Card. Okay. The turbograv lift rapidly gains speed. It lashes past hundreds of occupied rooms. Then it decelerates quickly. It comes to a stop. There, we got a computer. Ah, I like the flamingos on the bedspread. That's nice. Turn on computer. The hotel computer. A metallic voice says, "This is the Pink Flamingo main computer. Enter your command. Send Leela." Okay. Leela enters the room and says, "I understand you're the man with the big thruster." I certainly am, Leela. I certainly am. You sure you aren't sure if she's talking about your ship or your... Okay, so you're not going to see this part on the video. so that should be exciting. You are in bed with Leela. You are both completely nude. She is very vulnerable. Make love. You lie beside her and stroke her soft flesh. Your hands begin with her hair and move to her. Suddenly and quickly, you seize each other and make mad, passionate love together. Wonderful. I personally like to talk afterwards. Leela yawns, then purrs. Actually, I was once contacted by the tribe, but I've had no further contact since. They live on the hidden planet Mondo, but I do not know its location. I do remember one of them talking about trading goods. They talked about trading goods with the man on Space Station X. She sends the coordinates of the space station to Sandy via the bedside terminal. She then dresses, kisses you, and leaves. Lord. You're in the bathroom of your hotel room. Your room is to the west. An instant woman vending machine is near the toilet. You know I gotta put the coin in. And the coin is in your hand. Coin drops into the machine. Out of the machine pops an instant woman capsule that says, just add... Oh, thank God, it's water. Just add water. You place the capsule in your pocket. Okay. Now, I think we should get out of here. Go back to the hotel room. Let's get in the ship. We're not able to go up. In the ship. Okay. I don't want to do that. Okay. Get in the ship. Okay. Go north. Go north. Sit at your ship. Blast off. Yes, I know. I barely feel the thrusters. How exciting. Many days pass. Hi, Brad. This is Sandy. We've arrived at Space Station X. We are docked at the station at the station's main airlock. Wonderful. Get up. Get up. Go back to the airlock. Open the airlock. I'm sorry, this is really dull, but this game is really dull. Go through the airlock. Okay. You enter the airlock of Space Station X. The airlock's face is south. Big thruster is north. Okay. Let's go any direction. No, I didn't want to. Go back in the airlock. Open the airlock. The airship passageway is north. The airlock faces south. Go south. Okay. Okay, now I'm here. Can we go west? No. Can we open this airlock? It opens and you step through. Okay. You're in the main passageway of Space Station X. North is the Space Station airlock. South is Space Station Control. East is crew berthing. West is the automated galley and assembly room. Let's go to the galley. You're in the automated Space Station galley of Space Station. East, oh my god. West is the assembly room. Eat. Cherry. You hungrily eat a cherry. Thank God. You're in the control room of Space Station X. Standing in the control room is the station commander. He is the grizzled veteran of many wars. He is the type you would expect to have illegal dealings with outlaw groups. to the north is the space station passageway. Get capsule. Capsule's in your hand. Give. Capsule. Cap. The commander grabs the capsule in excitement. Yes, I know where Mondo is located, he says. He opens a comm line to the big thruster. He sends the coordinates for Mondo. He then grabs a glass of water and runs out of the room. With information, you head back to big thruster. As you walk up the passageway, you hear the sounds of passionate lovemaking come from the room of the door behind you of the bunk. Wonderful. Just wonderful. Sit at the desk. Sit at the thing. Blast off. Yeah, I know. I barely feel the thrusters. I really, really get it. Hi, Brad. This is Sandy. We have landed on planet Mondo. We are in an uninhabited area. The atmosphere seems safe for humans. Well, that's good to know. Get up. Okay. Go south. Go south. Go south. We're at the airlock. Open the airlock. All right, we are outside. Oh my god. Okay. Wonderful. Go east. You're walking around an all-green field among all of your beautiful flowers and strange mounds. Go west. Okay. Suddenly, horseback riders approach from a distance. They surround you. They are hostile, beautiful, young women of the tribe, armed with spears. They approach you, pointing their spears at you. They wait to see what you're going to do. Oh my god. You slowly remove your clothes. The beautiful young women are so impressed with your physique that they don't kill you, but instead take you captive. You are transported to a large futuristic city. They walk you through the streets to the palace where you are thrown into a basement cell. You are in a cell on planet Mondo, a prisoner of the tribe. Sharing your cell is Sheila, a vixen in trouble. Sheila knows how to escape. Of course she does. Come lie with me, lover. You're in bed with Sheila. You're both completely naked. She is not very vulnerable. Oh my god. People made these. People made these games. She roughly pulls you close to her in the bunk bed. She begins to stroke your entire body. You feel the heat rise within you. You embrace and engage in wild, crazy, heated sex. Afterwards, she rolls over and lies next to your fatigued body. Ask her a question. I can help you escape, Earthman. The main halls are too well patrolled, but I will show you a secret passage, Sheila says. She presses a hidden spot on the prison wall, and a panel door opens, revealing a dark hole. Course it is. As you peer into the dark hole, she pushes you from behind. You slide down the long tunnel. You finally land. Okay. Let's go east. You're standing in front of the control panel for a strange-looking ray gun. The panel contains many controls. Oh my god. Really? It has a herpes button. It has a herpes button. It has a herpes button. Why not just play Mario? Like, birth control? Well, I give it this. At least it has options for gay, straight, and bi. So it was very progressive for 1989. I'm gonna push the green button. Push green. The sex ray gun is energized. Push. Red button. Nothing seems to have happened. That's good. That's my whole sex life in a single sentence. Go west. Your hidden laboratory beneath. Yep, I know about that. Go west again. You're standing in a strange hallway, a few feet or yards of the palace guards. They see you! They rush forward and surround you. You're not able to go down. That is overwhelmingly ironic. Make love. Can't perform that command. You're not able to go down. You're naked. You have nothing. Wonderful. Make love. As before, the guards are so impressed with your charms, and instead of killing you on the spot, they roughly drag you down the hall and take you to their beautiful queen, La Lust. You are in the great hall, in the throne room of the queen of the tribe. Her beautiful eyes look at you measuringly. I've heard a lot about you, Captain Stallion. Oh, your big thruster is legendary. Lala says, is she talking about your spaceship, or... Lala lies completely naked to your eyes. Her pale white skin is smooth and firm. Her body squirms on the silk cushion. Make love. Come and lie beside me, lover. Oh my god. She laughs at you. You were good, but watch this. I have the sex ray gun. It can drain sex from 1,000 men and store it for my pleasure. At my command, it will give me the most. She reaches for her remote control unit and presses the button. There is a thunderous explosion as the sex ray gun self-destructs. The whole planet, palace rocks as the other stored explosives begin to detonate. Let's get out of here. You're in the palace flight hangar. An open skylight reveals a possible means of escape. The door to the great hall is west. Near you are winged sky bikes. Ride bike. You mount the bike and go. The sky bike deposits you next to the big thruster. All around you are the green fields of Mondo. Above you is the airlock. You're back in the control room of the big thruster. You feel the ground shaking through the steel decks. The captain's chair is near you. Sit in the chair. Blast off. You blast off just in time. Big thruster heads for deep space. Just as you relax, you hear someone step into the control room. It's Sheila, the guard that helped you escape. She smiles. Can Big Thruster handle one more? Oh my god. Is she talking about... Who cares? Yes, thank you. Who cares? No matter what she's talking about, the answer is a definite yes. As a matter of fact, you may take the long way home. Congratulations, Brad. You have completed your mission, and you've completed your mission successfully. You win. Is that it? You're not able to go west. You're not able to go south. You're not able to go east. You're not able to go north. So that's it. That is the end. That was painful. That was really painful. What's more painful is that I have to edit this. Like, I have to edit it down. Sex Vixens from Space. So I hope you enjoyed that. That was the whole game. That's it. If you wasted your money in 1989, I feel really bad for you. So yeah, have a good day. Thanks for watching. I hope it was everything you've been dreaming of since 1989, when you couldn't get your hands on it. Next time I will make a better video.